Hello. Let us now consider the system of indistinguishable particles. Let us consider a system of n identical non-interacting particles. Identical non-interacting particles. So the Hamiltonian of the system is the sum of the Hamiltonian of individual particles, because there is no interaction, so the interaction potential energy is zero. So total energy is the sum of the energies of individual particles. The time independent Schrodinger equation is h psi of q is equal to e psi of q. Okay, where h is the Hamiltonian of the system. Now, the solution of the Schrodinger equation is therefore equal to psi is equal to the product of individual wave functions ui, and the total energy E, that is the eigenvalue of the Hamiltonian H, E is equal to sum of ei, I equal to 1 to n, where here ei is the eigenvalue of the individual Hamiltonian Hi, and ui is the wave function or eigenfunction of individual particle. Now, therefore, the individual particle Schrodinger equation Hi ui is equal to ei ui, h1 u1 is equal to e1 u1. Okay, now let us consider the general case. There may be ni number of particles in the energy state with energy ei. So there may be number of particles n1, number of particles in this state, n2, number of particles in this state, n3, number of particles in this state, etc., ni, number of particles in this state. This is ei, e3, e2, and e. Okay, so this is. Therefore, we can write a set of numbers ni. This is the This describes a state of system. Normally, for example, we have a total 100 number of particles. So, one state, this some number of particles, in this state some number of particles. Okay. Not all the system can have like this. Okay, that depends on different quantum systems. So that here ni represent a state of a system, therefore we can write the total number of particles that is given by summation ni is equal to total number of particles n. So the total will be 100 in this case. Okay, and the total energy of the system also can be written as energies of the individual particles, sum of the energies of individual particles. So ni ei is equal to total energy E. Okay. Therefore, the corresponding wave function of the system is equal to psi is equal to the product of the wave function of, so this is equal to q1 of m, or m is equal to q1 to n1. So these all the n1 particles are having the wave function u1, and their argument is, or the coordinates are different. So the m is the coordinate of first particle. So here 2 represent the coordinate q2. Actually, this is qm. Okay, then this represent qm. So qm represent the coordinate of mth particle. So here this m is from first particle up to n1th particle, and again here again product into q2 of m, here m from next n1 plus 1 up to n1 plus n2 particle, etc. So this goes like this. Now let us consider, we interchange particle between the state. So a particle from this state to a particle this state. So we interchange this particle. Okay. So interchange means the argument just changed. Like that, we can interchange many number of particles, or we effect a permutation among the coordinates. So therefore, p psi is equal to the corresponding wave functions is p psi m1 to n, m equal to 1 to n, n1, u1 of the permuted wave function of first particle will be u1 of pm1, like that, and up to n1 particle. M is equal to n1 plus 1 to n1 plus n2 of u into u2, the product of u1, all the u1, then the product of all u2s in, okay, u3, etc. So, if an interchange of particles happens, then the corresponding wave function, the resulting wave function is p psi is equal to this much. Now, in classical physics, even though particles are identical, they are considered as distinguishable particles. If they are distinguishable, an interchange of particles between two states, that is a particle from one state to another, that means a particle in the third state to first state, if they interchange, the particle of the third state goes to particle in the part goes to the first energy level, and the particle in the first energy goes to the third state. So the interchange of particle between state can result in a new wave function, sorry, new state. Appo rendu particle angottu kodu interchange cheythu kaniyali appo oru pudhiya state varum, angane total number of microstate with all the different permutation is the number of microstate with this permutation is number of microstate is equal to n factorial divided by n1 factorial, n2 factorial, n3 factorial, etc. Okay, the number already derived cheyidanadu engiyanu nammal, we have total n number of particles. Out of this n, n1 particles are distributed in the first level. How many number of permutation is allowed? The total number of ways in which the particles n1 number of particles distributed in the first energy. Yes, total n number le edengilum n1 number of particles 100th state distribute cheyanulla total number of ways nu parayunnathu total number of ways nu parayunnathu ncn1. Similarly, now how n minus n1 particle exists. N minus n1 particle, now I wanted to take n2 particle, any of n2 particles. So the total number of ways is ncn2. Similarly, so the total number of ways in which particles n2 particles distributed in n2 number of particles distributed in the state E2 is n minus n1 cn2. Now the total number of exist is n minus n1 minus n2. Now I wanted to distribute n3, any n3 number of particles from this number of particles. So the total number of ways is n minus n1 minus n2 cn3. So the total number of ways in which all this permutation happens is simultaneously happens is equal to n cn1 into n minus n1 cn2 into n minus n1 minus n2 cn3, etc. Okay, so this will become n factorial divided by n minus n1 factorial n1 factorial. This is n minus n1 factorial divided by n minus n1 minus n2 factorial into n2 factorial. This becomes n minus n1 minus n2 factorial divided by n minus n1 minus n2 minus n3 factorial into n3 factorial. This goes like this. So the total number of ways in which the particles are distributed, this get cancelled with this thing, and this get cancelled with this thing, this get cancelled with the next thing. So the what is remaining, the total number of ways is n factorial divided by n1 factorial, n2 factorial, n3 factorial. So this is the total number of microstates of the classical particles which are distinguishable. Okay, so the statistical weight factor for the distribution function, this number is the statistical weight factor for the distribution set Ni. Now if the system is having the particles with or the particles are inherently indistinguishable, then we have to apply the Gibbs correction. So if we apply Gibbs correction, then the statistical weight factor, this number reduces to reduced by a factor n factor. So the weight factor, statistical weight factor, classical value of the statistical weight factor for the distribution set Ni is equal to 1 by n1 factorial, n2 factorial, n3 factorial. So we have divided this number by n factorial. So this is the case of classical, for classical systems. Now, according to quantum physics, interchange of particles will not result in a new microstate because they are indistinguishable. They are identical. Identical particle angottum ingottum exchange cheythu ennu karuthi pudhiya microstate aavunnilla. Number of particles, ore state ilulla number of particles are fixed. Number of particles fixed aanengil pudhiya microstate undalla. Particles in ennam maarumbo pudhiya microstate. അപ്പോൾ ഇത് ഐഡൻറ്റിക്കൽ ആയതുകൊണ്ട് ക്വാണ്ടം സിസ്റ്റത്തിൽ പുതിയ മൈക്രോസ്റ്റേറ്റ് ഉണ്ടാകുന്നില്ല. ദർ ഫോർ ഫോർ എ പർട്ടിക്കുലർ ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ സെറ്റ് എൻ ഐ സ്റ്റാറ്റിസ്റ്റിക്കൽ വെയ്റ്റ് ഫാക്ടർ ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു വൺ ഫോർ ഓൾ സെറ്റ് ഓൾ അലോഡ് സെറ്റ്. ഇഫ് ദ ദിസ് ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ ഈസ് നോട്ട് അലൗഡ് ദെൻ the statistical weight factor for the particular set of numbers is zero. Okay, adayathu particles interchange cheythu kaniyal undala karanam endanu number fixed aanu pakshe ore state ilulla number fixed aanu endittu number fixed aakkittu particle angottum ingottum ore particle maatti ennu parna idu identical aayathondu pudhiya microstate aavunnilla. Therefore the statistical weight factor is 1. Therefore, the wave function of the system, wave function of the system of n particles, that is psi, is equal to product u1 of m, u2 of m, product u3 of m, here m is equal to 1 to n1. M equal to n1 plus 1 to n1 plus n2. Here m is n1 plus n2 plus 1 up to n plus n2 plus n3, etc. So this wave function is not enough for this describing the quantum mechanical system of distinguishable, indistinguishable particles. Indistinguishable particle in the case ile ee oru not enough kaaranam interchange cheythu kaniyal ee wave function maari po wave function maari kaniyal physically adayathu indine mathematical form maari po angane varumbo nammude microstate maarathondu ee ide wave function maarunnilla ennu parnju ennalum adayathu microstate pudiyathu undavunnilla ennu parnju kaaranam particles are indistinguishable. അപ്പോൾ ഈ വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ ഉപയോഗിച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ ഇവിടെ മാറുന്നുണ്ട്. കാരണം ഇതിൻ്റെ ആർഗ്യുമെൻറ്റ് വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ്റെ കോർഡിനേറ്റ്സ് മാറിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ മാറും. അപ്പോൾ ഇത് ഉപയോഗിക്കാൻ പറ്റില്ല. അങ്ങനെയാണെന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ നമ്മൾ എന്താ ചെയ്യാം? ഇതുപോലെ പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻ ഉണ്ടാവുന്ന എന്തുപോലെ ഒരു പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻ ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ എന്തോ എന്ത് സംഭവിക്കും? ദിസ് ബിക്കംസ് യു വൺ ഓഫ് പി എം പ്രോഡക്റ്റ് യു ടു ഓഫ് പി എം പ്രോഡക്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ത്രീ ഓഫ് പി എം. ഇതുപോലെ തന്നെ എമ്മിൻ്റെ വാല്യൂസ് ആസ് ബിഫോർ. അപ്പോൾ ഇങ്ങനെ പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻ അതായത് എക്സ്ചേഞ്ച് പാർട്ടിക്കൽ എക്സ്ചേഞ്ച് കൊണ്ട് ഉണ്ടാകുന്ന ഓൾ പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻസ് എടുക്കുക എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ എൻ ഫാക്ടോറിയൽ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻസ് പോസിബിൾ ആണ്. ഇഫ് ദർ ആർ എൻ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസ് ദെൻ ദ എൻ ഫാക്ടോറിയൽ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻ. അങ്ങനെയാണെന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ദ ടോട്ടൽ വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് നമ്മുടെ വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് പുതിയ മൈക്രോസ്റ്റേറ്റ് ഉണ്ടാവുന്നില്ലെങ്കിൽ it should be expressed as a linear combination of all these permutation. Okay, appo oru baad permuted wave function nasavattum adu pole ee oru wave function undu aganulla ella wave function ney linear combination aayittu edunna aa pudhiya wave function aanu nammude ee quantum systemile wave functions wave function ennu parayunnu. Okay, appo namukku ee wave function ee first permute cheyatha initial wave function ennu parayunnathu വിതൗട്ട് എനി എക്സ്ചേഞ്ച് അതിനെ നമ്മൾ ബോൾസ്മാനിയൻ വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ പറയും. സൈ ബോൾസ്മാനിയൻ. ഓക്കെ, സോ സൈ ബോൾസ്മാനിയൻ്റെ ബാക്കിയുള്ള എല്ലാ പെർമ്യൂട്ടഡ് എത്ര നമ്പർ ഓഫ് ഒരു ഒരു പാർട്ടുകൾ രണ്ട് ഒരു പെയർ ഓഫ് പാർട്ടുകൾ എക്സ്ചേഞ്ച് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഇത് പി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് വണ്ണാണ്, ഒരു ഒറ്റ പ്രാവശ്യം പെർമ്യൂട്ടേഷൻ നടത്തി. അങ്ങനെയുള്ള ഡിഫറൻറ്റ് എൻ ഫാക്ടോറിയൽ ടൈംസ് ഉള്ള ഡിഫറെൻ്റ് കോമ്പിനേഷൻസ് എടുക്കുക. അതിൻ്റെ എല്ലാത്തിൻ്റെയും ലീനിയർ കോമ്പിനേഷനായിട്ട് എഴുതുന്ന ആ പുതിയ വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ ആയിരിക്കും നമ്മുടെ ക്വാണ്ടം സിസ്റ്റത്തിനെ ഡിസ്ക്രൈബ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. അങ്ങനെ വരുമ്പോൾ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ നോട്ട് പ്രൊഡ്യൂസ് എനി ന്യൂ, ദ പാർട്ടിക്കൽ എക്സ്ചേഞ്ച് വിൽ നോട്ട് പ്രൊഡ്യൂസ് എനി ന്യൂ മൈക്രോസ്റ്റേറ്റ്. ദെർഫോർ പുതിയ മൈക്രോസ്റ്റേറ്റ് ഉണ്ടാവുന്നില്ല എന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ദ ന്യൂ മൈ ന്യൂ വേവ് ഫംഗ്ഷൻ പി സൈ സ്ക്വയർ is equal to psi square. The probability should be the same. Okay. So, for this to happen, there are two possibilities. One possibility is p psi is equal to psi for all p. Any number of permutation, p psi is equal to psi for all p. So, such a wave function is called symmetric. Okay. Now, another possibility. This to be happen. We have other possibilities. One is P psi equal to psi plus psi. Okay. For even number of permutations. Okay. Or P psi is equal to negative root minus psi. Then also mod square becomes psi square. So for odd number of permutations. So odd number of permutation, then this become negative. Okay, so we can write this two. This wave function is called, then wave function is termed as psi is termed as anti-symmetric wave function. So in some systems, this may be symmetric wave function, psi may be symmetric wave function, which is the linear combination. And here psi is the psi is anti-symmetric because for odd permutation this get minus negative of the psi. So we can write the symmetric wave function psi s is equal to linear combination of P psi force minus for odd. So this is the sum of all the P up to as much number. Okay, into a constant in this. So it should be multiplied by a factor. So this is for all. Okay. So, and for anti-symmetric case, here this is equal to P psi Boltzmannian, but with a factor A, a constant A, but for odd P, odd number of permutation, it should be negative. Therefore, we have to multiply it with it. And for even, it is for even P, this should be, this is positive. Therefore, we have to multiply a factor inside. Okay. So for all P, here delta P is equal to plus 1 for even P and delta P is equal to minus 1 for odd. So if we apply this thing, the alternative terms will be positive and negative. So this is the case of the quantum system. So for quantum mechanical system, we have two kinds of functions. One is symmetric, where all the permutation will not result. All the permutation giving rise to a positive term. But for odd permutation, this is negative, and for even permutation, this is positive in this case of anti-symmetric wave function. Now, this anti-symmetric wave function, if this is the case, the anti-symmetric wave function can be written in the form of a determinant. Okay, determinant. This is called a Slater determinant. So, psi A can be written as a Slater determinant. The anti-symmetric wave function psi A can be written as u1 of 1, u1 of 2, u1 of 3, etc., u1 of n. Similarly, u2 of 1, u2 of 2, u2 of 3, etc. u2 of n. Similarly, ui of 1, ui of 2, ui of 3, etc. ui of n. So this leading diagonal represents the Boltzmann. Okay. So we'll have, so there is a factor, a constant deviation. There is a constant deviation. So A into we can analyze this anti-symmetric wave function now. So if we change two particles, or if we interchange the particles 1 and 2. So this column get exchanged. When this column interchange, then what happens to this determinant? If you exchange the column once, then the determinant become psi A, become minus psi A. Okay. So that if you interchange two columns, that means corresponds to two permutations, then it again get positive, psi A become plus I. So odd number of permutation, that means odd number of exchange of columns, okay, corresponds to negative value for the determinant. Therefore, this Slater determinant is used for specifying anti-symmetric wave functions. Okay, so that's all. So this is called Slater determinant. So we'll continue discussion in next video. Thank you.